Hey everybody, you want to be like June Regalado, just remember, you can't. You gotta be an original drummer, alright? Whatever he teaches you is what he probably had learned, but you have to apply to what he teaches you and make it your own sound, make it your own beat, make it your own rhythm. June Regalado is the most recorded drummer in Asia, and he's soon to be the most recorded drummer in the world. Can you hang with that? I don't think so. So don't even try. Be yourself. Be an original.
At saka yung drummer ninyo yan. Yung pangalan niya, June Regalado na yan. Ang awardee ng kata, Drummer of the Century.
Imaginin mo.
June Regalado.
Ang kasama namin dito, Drummer of the Century.
Of the Century.
The most notable names in the music industry has played alongside the biggest names in music, including DST and Company.
Uy, was... teacher namin yan.
Aba?
Teacher namin yan.
Talaga?
Paano nga ba natin masasabi na magaling ang isang drummer? Kung tatanungin ng mga drummer, ang maririnig mo na sagot kadalasan, speed, technical skills, sight reading, at iba pa. Pero sa tingin ko, mas dapat nating tanungin ang mga hindi drummer. Yung mga artist mismo ang tanungin natin. Bakit nila inaasahan ang isang June Regalado pagdating sa drum set? Sa panahon na wala pang digital metronome, makaluma pa ang pag-record ng mga kanta. Bakit June Regalado ang pinagkakatiwalaan ng mga music director sa studio at ng mga artist bilang backbone ng mga awitin na tumatak na sa kultura ng Pilipinas at sa puso at isip ng mga Pilipino? Pati sa concert, tatawagan siya ng mga Filipino artist kahit sa ibang bansa ang concert nila. Papali pa rin from country to country. Gagastosan sa hotel na tutuluyan para lang siya ang pumalo sa concert nila. 1999, Katha Music Award, Most Outstanding Musician. 1999, Awit Award, Most Valuable Participation to the Development of the Music Industry. 2018, Aliw Award, Lifetime Achievement, Endorser ng Zildjian Cymbals and Drumsticks, Premier Drums at Shure Microphones. Kilalanin natin ang most recorded drummer in Asia at alamin gaano kagaling si June Regalado. Precision. Umatend ako sa isang drum clinic noon ni Tatay June. Naikwento niya ang experience niya sa recording ng jingles para sa commercials. Mahalang bayad para mailabas ang commercial sa TV. Segundo ang binabayaran. Kung kaya dapat sakto lang sa given time ang isang jingle. Kaya kapag nag-record at lumampas ng isa o dalawang segundo, alam na niya kung paano mag-a-adjust para maisakto na sa time limit sa pangalawang recording. Take note, ito ay time na wala pang metronome na ginagamit sa studio.
First of all, the precision is there. Si Junreg, sabihan mo na we are 1 second too long sa sunod na pasada, exacto na yung timing. Alam niya. And that's something that can be taught because sanayan yan eh. That can only come from years and years and years of experience.
Tsaka same thing with the drummer. You have to have that natural pulse, no, na steady yung pulse. Yung para sa akin yun. Kaya that's why up to now, we still work together. No? I still work with June. Dahil para sa akin, sa Pilipinas, no? Sa lahat ng mga katrabaho ko, siya yung pinaka-steady yung pulse. No? Hindi sobra, hindi kulang yung palo niya.
I had the pleasure na makabisita sa bahay at music room ni Tatay June. May pinakita siya sa akin na drum duet video nila ng anak niya na si Sir Junjun Regalado noong 90s. Evident ang precision sa drum duet nila. Kahit walang in-ear monitor at magkalayo pa sila sa stage, makikitang nagkakasabay pa rin talaga sila ng palo. Nakita ko pa nga at nahawakan ang mismong kulintang na ginamit nila noon sa live drum duet nila na yun. Nandun sa sulok ng music room ni Tatay June.
Iwas. Andito pala yung kulintang?
Oo.
Ayan guys, so, kulintang. Sige. Ito po ba yung ginamit nyo nung ano? Yung duet nyo?
Oo. Yan.
Ah, ito yung kulintang. Galing nung duet na yun.
Next, versatility.
Si Jun Regalado, kasama namin yan since, well, when I started, siya na yung drummer ko. At what I used to do is, I'd ask him for to write for me different passages, kung ano ba yung pop rock, ano ba yung rumba, mambo. During that time kasi, ang daming klaseng styles na ginagamit. Swing, fast swing, slow swing, medium swing, mga iba-ibang klase, rock. Si Jun, matututong niya lahat yun. As a matter of fact, he was our drummer. He was my drummer for the longest time. He recorded with me many, many artists like Basil, Haji, the White Society. At ang pagkakalam ko dyan kay Jun marami nang natuto sa kanya na drummers from different bands. Like yung drummer siguro na River Maya, Eraserheads, yung mga bata. Lahat, marami na pick up kay Jun Regalado.
Kung kahit na anong ipatugtog mo sa kanya, like, you know, I have Difficult Pieces by Ryan Gebb, I have like Corner of the Sky, meron namang parang semi-classical na nais ko. So iba-iba, no? Kahit ano ibigay mo sa kanya, kayang-kanyang tugtugin yun, so.
Almost lahat ng kanta ni Rico J, siya pumalot. May istorya pa dyan. Yung, sa studio nung araw, mga kababayan ko, sa studio nung araw, siya po ay drummer ni Basil, drummer ni Rico, drummer ni Haji. In one day, iniikot niya yung buong tatlong studio. Totoo yan. Totoo yan. Wala pong bulan yan. Siya po ang in-demand drummer nung panahon na yun.
Sa susunod may papakita ko na video clip, mapapahanga ka talaga. Hindi lang siya nakakatugtog ng iba't ibang style ng musika, kaya pa niya itong pagsabay-sabayin. Panoorin.
Isa ka lang drummer, merong orkestra dito sa kanan mo. Gusto niyang tumugtog ng In the Mood, let's say, In the Mood. Yung namang ballroom orkestra dito, ballroom dancing orkestra, waltz naman ang gustong draman mo. So, let's say, ta ta da 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 ta da 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 da. Okay. May dumating pa ngayon dancer. Tahis yan. Ang gusto nilang ano. So, wala ka na natitira, no? Yung tahis yan. No? Eh, gusto nila, sabay-sabay mo silang dutraman. Let's say, okay, ito yung sa In the Mood. Tapos, sasayaw na yung Tahitian. Eh, gusto na rin tumugtog ng ano, nung waltz.
At time, even when he was so young, he was already our number one drummer. Whatever recording that you listen to today, that's him playing the drums.
Musicality. Ang isang magaling na drummer ay may mataas na antas ng musicianship. Ito yung tinatawag na thinking in sound at pagkakaroon ng sensitivity sa musika.
Proto timpani, ito yung
proto. Ayo nga. Ang laki ng
tinutukoy. The second, which is really tremendous for a percussion artist, the musicality. Alam mo, hindi natin ina-associate ang drums sa tono kasi para sa atin sila yung tempo. Pero hindi eh. Si June, napapakanta niya yung drums. Talagang may tonong lumalabas. Kung kaya't hindi ako natatakot na drums lang ang nag-accompany nung kanta. Okay lang, basta si June Reg ang nandoon sa drums, alam ko may tonong lalabas eh. Talagang may tono at buo pa rin yung kantang yon. This is a sense of musicality that comes naman from knowledge of the instrument.
Pansinin ninyo kung saan nakatingin si Martin Rivera. Panoorin niyo kung paano siya nakikipagpakiramdaman sa banda kung kailan sila babalik. At pakinggan niyo rin kung ano tinutugtog ni Tatay Jun.
Cesar Aguas yung
okay.
Na yun, dahil naman ang mukha niya.
Ayan. Anyway, you know, before you left, you said you were going away to find your smile. Did you find your smile?
When we come back, we'll find out.
Well, yeah, but are you really all right? Also, when we come back.
Let's find out.
Also, when we come back. We will find out more about Martin Rivera when Sharon returns. More
than no fire. Hey sir, Mr. Regalado, I just want to say, wow, 50 years in the business, man. That's truly an inspiration by myself and, of course, by everyone here. You guys have set the foundation of what we do, what we love to do. Your son's right here, loves you very much. Want to say, have a good one. Thank you. I wouldn't be doing this with this guy right here, right? This guy's crazy.
All
right,
Daddy. All right. Thank you for
congratulations. Congratulations. I'm my family now. Daddy.
Yeah.
Okay, Daddy.
Siguro sa experience, no, like marami rin naman ako experience as a band member, pero iba na talaga pag may experience ka sa banda tulad ni John, at the same time sight reader ka.
Passion niya talaga ang pagda-drums. Mahal niya ang ginagawa niya. So nakita ko sa kanya, passion leads to excellence, excellence leads to more gigs leads to more experience. At kapag masyado ng malawak ang experience, wala kang choice kundi maging magaling. Precision, check. Versatility, check. Musicality, check. Passion, check. Idagdag pa natin ang attitude and professionalism. Hindi ka pwedeng maging greatest drummer kung wala ka nito.
Hey June, this is your friend David Pomerantz, and I'm sorry I couldn't be with you tonight at your celebration, but I wanted to let you know how much you mean to us, what an incredible drummer you are. Playing with you is a dream. Always in the pocket, always perfect, and best of all, honestly, is what a decent, great guy you are. You light up the rehearsals, you light up the stage and the concert hall. So it's always a joy to play with you.
Ginawa ko ang video na to para maging inspirasyon sa kabataan na gustong i-pursue ang kanilang pangarap sa larangan ng musika. At bilang pagtatapos, makinig muli tayo sa isang performance mula sa ating greatest Pinoy drummer, June Regalado.
And the one person who helped us get started as a band, yung ama ng aming drummer, ni Sininho Regalado, ay drummer din. In fact, musicians in the Philippines, they call him the king of drums. Tito mo yun. Why? Because of his ability as a drummer. Super galing. And yung proof noon, he was able to record thousands and thousands of songs sa mga album, making him the most recorded musician in the Philippines. Pero, hindi kami nagkaroon ng opportunity to perform with him. Kasi we were not worthy. We were not worthy to perform back then with the one and only Mr. June Regalado. But tonight, something really special is going to happen on stage. We invited Mr. June Regalado to do something special with us. New callers and Mr. June Regalado.
June Regalado.